first step for this CAD challenge is to create a series of golden ratio rectangles at different orientations to define the vertices of the icosahedron we'll use as a template for a bunch of other features later on. The reason why I use 10 and not 1 on that side, and multiply the other one by 10, is just so it's easier to see, because otherwise it's kind of hard to see something that's 1 millimeter. Here I'm copying and pasting it to other orientations with Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V. Here we rotate it 90 degrees to get that final orientation. The next step is creating the icosahedron itself by using the convex polyhedron feature script. This creates the solid, and now we can go on transforming it and doing other stuff to it. First we need to measure that distance, which is defined in the specification as 40 millimeters. So here I'm going to use the scale feature to scale it up to the appropriate size. The next step after this is to make all of the fillets at the corners where the edges, like the edge thingamajigs, come together. The radius is 1 for all of them, and the origin is deselected because we don't actually have anything at the center. Next we create another part studio where we're just going to make a quick sketch with a 2 mm circle, which is going to define the profile for the edge thingamajigs that we run along the edges. So here we use the beam feature script, which is meant for like weldments and that sort of stuff, but it's pretty cool because you can use it for stuff like this with a custom profile, and then you can automatically create the edge thingamajigs. Finally, I just delete the scaffolding solid that we created and boolean all it together to bring it all together. Now, there might be some small differences in the measured volume and surface area when compared with Inventor, because Onshape uses the Parasolid kernel while Inventor uses the Shape Manager one. Thanks for watching.